first song in the Eventi d'Azzurro show. Benvenuti tutti quanti. And of course, a warmly welcome to all of you. Goedenavond allemaal. Bonsoir. En herzlich willkommen. Goedenavond. Euch alle. So, this is the international start of the show. And of course, we started with Gazebo with the first. I thought it was an appropriate song to kick off this wonderful show, because I think it will be wonderful. Maybe it could be an anthem for the upcoming month, and it's not because of Corona or whatever, but you know, in these difficult times, it could be wonderful to find your friends at the radio. And of course, I'm happy to say that we do here at Radio Stad Den Haag, and with Eventi d'Azzurro, we all feel the connection. We all are the big family, as Sergi Elias always stated before, and still he does. So, well, what better can we do than look for direct contact? And we try for the first time now with a fan, because we, with the artists, we did already in the past. But with a fan, no, we didn't do that so much before. With Arek and Darek in Rome, it's true. These are the real names, because they are Polish guys in Rome. Darek is the father, papa, and Arek is his son. Well, last week you could hear already the announcement of this upcoming... Well, it's not really an intervista, it's not really an interview, but it's more like a conversation about what we think is the best in life, Italo Disco. And I'm going to ask, of course, these wonderful friends how important Italo Disco is for their lives. And we have met those guys in Milano. Also, not to forget the wonderful Mama. But, of course, I know a little bit more than you at the other side of the radio at the moment. But, well, shortly you will get to know these wonderful persons. And I know these are just examples of you guys out there, and girls, not to forget the girls, because if you see what Kirsi is writing here in the chat, she's always happy, she's always very much with her heart with the Italo Disco songs or the Euro Disco songs. So you will recognize the feeling, you will recognize all that Arek is going to say. But first, if it's going to be, well, if the connection will be all right, we're going to have a little chit-chat with Darek, his father, papa. And then, after some songs, we will move on to Arek and ask how his life is with, well, these wonderful times, according to the music maybe, but difficult times regarding to the economic situation, well, not only in Italy, but all over. And he's a young guy, he's 24 years old, so I'm really curious to find out something about his passion, because he's too young to have revived or vived the 80s, but still, of course, with a father like Darek, how can you miss those wonderful tunes? They have thousands of Italo Disco tracks in their home. So, this is just a little bit of an information. In the first hour, you will hear the biggest of the Italo Disco hits selected by them. It was like a top 10? No. It must be a top 15? No. A top 20? No. A top 25? No. A top 30? You know the feeling when you have to select your songs. So it's going to be with the biggest ones. And of course, I will surprise them with some of the nicest songs that I have selected for my archives, because that's what friends are for, right? So let's move on to one of the first singles that was selected by Darek, by Papa. And we're going to try to find him on the Skype if possible. But, well, suppose there is a difficulty in connection, this is already what you have. This is the Delicate with the Keep On Music. think we succeeded in having the contact, un contatto con Roma. Ciao Dare, come va? Mi senti?
Eccomi.
Ehi, ecco.
Pronti?
Sì, siamo pronti.
Buonasera.
Buonasera, siamo prontissimi qui. I have to explain to the listeners in English. Mi scusi, Darek.
Vai tranquillo.
It's not supposed to be in Italian, but for Darek it's difficult to have a conversation in English. So don't worry, I will translate, of course, and later on with Arik it will be no problem. And if it's necessary, I will explain it anyway, because I think we have to have the wonderful connection now we have it. Allora, Darek, prima domanda. Come la vita adesso con Italo Disco per te? Perché in casa voi avete tantissimi pezzi Italo Disco, vero?
Certo. Certo, ce l'abbiamo tutti i pezzi di Italo Disco. A noi non può mancare niente di Italo Disco.
Perché?
Assolutamente.
Perché una vita senza Italo Disco non c'è, vero? Non esiste. Ah, non esiste. Ecco, ok.
Non esiste proprio.
Non esiste proprio. I asked him, well, how is possible maybe, or what's the situation at your home living with Italo Disco? Well, he said there is no life without Italo Disco. They have so many songs they can choose. Well, thousands of tracks, and I have seen just a little selection of what they liked, and these are the big names, like Danny Keith with the Keep Your Music, of course, and following. Darek, il prossimo pezzo sarà del tuo lista, Mi Commission, because, well, perché abbiamo selezionato qualche pezzi del tuo top 10, e niente, tu sei stato con noi tutti a Milano, che è stata l'impressione? Come un fan, come un veramente un tifoso per la musica Italo Disco, com'è stata l'impressione, la tua emozione? Dimmi.
Emozione quella più grande era questa, che potevamo incontrare tutti gli artisti, questi che sono stati presenti, qualcuno di loro non è stato presente, però quelli che sono stati presenti, a incontrare e scambiare due parole con loro, come hanno creato i suoi brani e tutto quanto. Questo era stato veramente un momento grande.
Sì,
E poi noi con Alex siamo impegnati proprio di prendere tutti autografi di quel grande libro di Francesco Catalano Verina, di Italo Disco.
Hai visto?
E anche se ti ricordi benissimo, Marcello, che uno di questi libri era un regalo proprio per tuo compleanno, quindi sì, questo sì. È stato doppio piacere proprio, grandissimo piacere per noi.
Ok, traduco adesso. I asked him what could have been, could he tell us the emotion that he felt when he was in Milano, because the last time that we were together as friends, it was in Milano 2016, and if you were there, or maybe you remember the stories and have seen the photographs, 2016 has been the 30th anniversary celebration party of Eventi d'Azzurro in Milano. And you know, well, over all these years, I can really say that the artists and producers are friends. They are really wonderful people to talk with, and well, Darek said, it was really the emotion to meet all those artists in just a very relaxed atmosphere, a very relaxed surrounding with fans. You could ask, you could have a photograph. They have the autographs in their Italo Disco book that was over there. And I had the regalo from them. I was so proud to have this. And well, you know, this is really something that also is an expression of feeling connected, because I wanted to organize a party with all the friends assembled with the artist. No difficulties, no VIP selection, just all the fans together. So, Darek, c'è un cantante preferito o è molto pericoloso di chiederti chi è il tuo cantante preferito o un disco artist preferito? C'è o non c'è?
Uno veramente no, perché sono almeno 4, 5, 6 nomi, questi che non si può dire questo è il primo, quello secondo, sono per me tutti serie A, proprio come chiamo io, dei Italo-Disco.
Ah, sì.
Quindi allora posso dire Gianni Coraini, Vince Mancini,
sì.
Mico Michel, bella voce, bellissima, sì. Silvio Pozzoni, diciamo, bellissima voce, e artisti come Fred Ventura, niente, sono parecchi adesso. Non è facile dire tutto. Ecco, un grande amico nostro Stefano Brignoli e tanti belli,
esatto,
voci e tanti belli creatori dei brani fantastici.
Ok, traduco. I asked him, could there be one artist in particular being his favorite singer or maybe a producer? But he said, well, it's impossible. It's like having the Serie A, this, like the Champions League in the calcio, in the soccer, it's like all together there with all those favorite singers and producers. So it's impossible to select. But he said, of course, there are people who are easy to talk with. And you have seen the photograph in Facebook. I published a photograph of those two wonderful people, Darek and Arek, in the company of Albertone, of course. But he said there was also so much contact with Gianni Coraini, with Stefano Brignoli. There are so many of the artists very easy to talk with. Also Vince Lanzini. Well, I know for sure, for a fact, that he's a wonderful person indeed. So it is impossible to select. Allora, Darek, I think, credo, con i tuoi pezzi preferiti, scegliamo adesso quello di Mico Michel, vero?
Perfetto, perfettissimo.
Okay. Ascoltiamo. Here is how old are you, Mico Michel? And of course, I will surprise, ho una sorpresa anche per loro, perché non sanno che anche io selezionato qualche pezzi. E spero, veramente spero, che piaccia a voi, a voi a casa, oppure a voi in radio. So let's listen to what this beautiful piece of art still is. And you know what? I told you last week, Mico Michel is keen to have a new song. He wants to have a new song. So let's join forces and let's create something beautiful for this wonderful man called Mico Michel. And let's do it now with this golden oldie.
Open the door. Yes, I left.
A little bit, of course, for not being really into the live chat at the moment, because usually I try to take a look and not miss anything, maybe request or whatever. But of course, you can understand that we have so many things in our heads at the moment to have a wonderful interview and a conversation with Roma. We have the direct linea with Italia. But of course, I'm proud to see that there are a lot of good people, good friends in the live chat, and I'm so grateful because the remarks are great, and also, of course, they like and appreciate the song. So, Darek, dopo questo andiamo ad Arek con la sua lista, le sue emozioni, eccetera. Però adesso voglio in contrario, non chiedo una cosa a te, ma Darek, hai una cosa da chiedere a me. Darek, magari hai una cosa da sapere da me.
Certo,
sorpresa, io, sorpresa.
Diciamo che te conosco benissimo, però ci sono pochi segreti, però cioè, questo è interessante, sicuro una domanda semplice. Come sei andato con questa onda di questi suoni di Italo Disco?
Ok,
traduco. Dove l'hai sentito per prima volta? Come è successo che sei rimasto amante di quella musica per tutta la vita?
Sì, chiaro, ok, grazie. Traduco. I asked him, well, to be surprised maybe, that I asked him if there was a question for me. It's the other way around, so it was a surprise, but he has a wonderful question. He's asked me, what has been the motive, what has been the reason for me to specialize in Italo Disco? What was maybe the first impression that I had to be convinced to do something with Italo Disco? Well, it has been my favorite, or let's say, taste of music to have disco music in my home. And you can, of course, talk about Lime in Canada, Bobby Lana from America. In Germany, there was Leon Ross already, of course. There were so many artists already. Also, don't forget the sounds from Spain, that I was attracted to the disco music in general. But I discovered that most of the songs that I really liked from my heart were the ones related to Italy. Allora, ti dico, caro Darek, i primi stanno veramente disco songs dall'America, di Canada, di Germania, però ho scoperto quasi subito che i miei preferiti vengono dall'Italia. E poi ho veramente fatto una cosa molto speciale di andare in Italia, di trovare gli artisti, di trovare gli... Per esempio, Don't Cry Tonight di Savage. Don't Cry Tonight. Io pensavo in Olanda, ma che cazzo, chi è? Chi ha creato questa musica? Voglio conoscere chi è. E così, con questo motivo, sono andato in Italia per scoprire la musica, la casa discografica, come andare in Disco Magic, e poi incontrare anche Roberto Zanetti, Savage. è stato così e poi ho selezionato i miei dischi in una classifica di top 20 solo made in Italy. Per essere chiaro a tutti quanti in Olanda per i negozi di importazione o alla radio, la mia classifica made in Italy. Allora è andato così e sono un tifoso anch'io. Sono un fan. Okay. So I told him that I was really attracted to the songs, especially made in Italy. So I tried to specialize more because nobody else did, to have my top 20 selected by the songs only made in Italy. And this was the first start, but I wanted to have it clear that there were so many pirate stations with so many charts that if you had the possibility to see Eventi d'Azzurro, you may ask yourself, what the heck? What is this kind of chart? Well, I wanted it to be very clear from the beginning. This is the Made in Italy sound. And so that was the start. And I went to Italy because I was thinking by myself, Don't Cry Tonight, what a wonderful track. Who is the guy behind the track? This Zanetti, who is the guy? And I went into Disco Magic to get acquainted with Severo Lombardoni and Anna Lombardoni, his sister, the lovely sister. She's not really forgotten, but everybody's talking about Severo Lombardoni. But the real treasure inside Disco Magic for me was Anna Lombardoni. Really, she was. And of course, in the distribution, Paolo. He was really not the Paolo Jaden we know at the moment, but Paolo. So that was the motive to go there. Derek, voglio concludere la piccola conversazione con te con un grande hit di Gianni Coraini, di Ken Laszlo. È perfetto, hey, secondo me. Hey, Guy, esatto. E poi, dopo questo disco di Hey, Guy, andiamo ad Arek. Tuo figlio.
Perfetto.
Ok?
Sì, sì. Andiamo a gioventù dopo. Sì. Lasciamo spazio a gioventù.
Sì. Hai una voglia di dire qualcosa a tutti i fans in tutto il mondo e che ascoltano adesso il nostro show? Would you want to say something to the fans at the moment?
Io più di altro voglio salutare tutti artisti, i nostri amici del cuore di Italo Disco, e tutti i fan di Italo Disco di tutto il mondo, soprattutto un amico mio, un fratello per me, e abbiamo cresciuto insieme con Italo Disco.
I know.
Marek Korodinski.
Esatto.
Noi abbiamo cresciuto insieme da ragazzi con Italo Disco.
Okay.
Insieme.
Ok, grazie.
Quindi questo. Yeah. E niente, volevo salutare tutti quanti, anche amici miei qui di Roma, che è stato parecchio tempo qui a Roma, siamo diventati anche noi un po' romani.
Mm-hmm. Siamo di Roma.
Siamo di Roma e possiamo, quando, dico solo questo all'ultimo, quando il Papa Wojtyła hanno dato cittadinanza romana, hanno detto adesso sei diventato cittadino romano, devi dire qualcosa romano. E lui ha detto, damo se da fa.
Grazie Derek, andiamo con la musica. Ken,
grazie
Laszlo.
Di tutto, grazie di tutto.
Hey, hey guy, are you happy? I am Ken Laszlo, Radio Stan the Nag.
really remains such a wonderful track. And remember, Gianni Curaini is the big guy, the big friend, and he is, well, still going strong in the music scene and delivering wonderful tracks, sometimes by himself and sometimes with a cooperation with other artists. If it's really okay, I try to find another track by him later on in the show, because we have some time to spend to music tonight. Hello? Oh my God, it's such a nice track. So, we search for the connection again with Roma, because we promised not only to speak with Darek, and he said the last things that he could mention, something for the Roman friends, but also to all the people here assembled in the radio. Don't forget, he was saluting, he was sending his greetings to all of you, because he said, well, this is what the connection is, the love for Italo Disco, and of course at the end also for the friends that the family has in Rome. Well, one of the biggest friends that you can imagine, maybe the fanatism in the heart, is now in view in Skype. Arek, buonasera, ciao.
Ciao, buonasera, good evening.
Good evening. So, how are you doing, Arek?
Good. I'm feeling very good. Italo disco music is my life.
Yeah, it's your passion.
It's my life.
But is it
my passion? Yes.
Is it too easy to say that you have this wonderful affection for Italo disco because of your father, Darek, or did you develop it yourself?
Yes, my father Darek transmit me Italo disco when I was a young boy.
Yeah,
and Italo disco was the music who listening every day. Italo disco is music for. For go to sleep, for training, for is lifestyle. Italo disco is lifestyle.
Exactly. Thank you. Because you know, I ask you this because there are families maybe where Papa or Mama is really a fan of Italo disco, and then the kids, they reject maybe the taste of their father or the taste of their mama and have their own rock music or metal or whatever, but you have really discovered also the feeling, the emotion for Italo disco. Thank you for explaining. So is there something that is for you maybe the best to listen to? Is it romantic slow Italo? Is it more the powerful
yes.
Or because I
yes.
remember that you said something to me, but I wanted to have it to say that you say it now to the listeners of the radio. What could be your favorite Italo disco sound?
My favorite Italo disco sound is the sound who connect the many rock music guitar rock,
yeah,
and the sound of Italo disco, the sound of synthesizer, the melody, and some rock, because I love rock, and I listen rock music, I listen pop rock, mm-hmm. Number one is Italo disco, but the melody of rock, guitar rock, I like.
Yeah, rock. I think it's a wonderful explanation, and that's why you suggested also in your chart, Tension, My Dream.
Yes, yes.
That's
because I like is my favorite voice, Mauro Farina.
Yeah.
For me is. Is one of the best artists of Italo disco. They create some beautiful songs like Dedicate Keep on Music.
Yes. Yeah.
Me and my father number one on the fanatic list.
Yes.
And many other great phenomenally Radiorama. Radiorama is very, I like Radiorama because it's very hard sometimes.
It's strong.
And
it's
Mauro
really
Farina voice is phenomenal. It's phenomenal.
Yeah. So I think now you have explained what is your maybe best feeling with Italo Disco and your favorite tunes, like the strong beats and some of the guitars also.
And also Scotch, Vince Raccini.
Of course.
He's very energetic. He's number one of energetic.
We're going to listen. We're going to listen for sure.
My favorite. My favorite. Vince Raccini, grande.
Yeah, we're going to listen to Scotch. We're going to listen to Scorch later on. And first, of course, we're going to listen to one of your other favorites, because you know that the combination is always, with Italo Disco music, the connection with the artist or the producer himself or herself, maybe, if it's a cantante, a female singer. So we have had this little discussion before, and you said, I think the connection between your dad's list of Darek and your one could be Albert One, because the Heart on Fire, the Heart on Fire, is something that is really explaining where the Italo Disco feeling is in your heart, and your heart is on fire, and your heart is on fire for Italo Disco music. So I suggest afterwards we're going to talk about Albertone, but first we're going to listen to Albert One. Is that correct? Is that okay with you?
Yes, it's very okay. It's very okay.
Okay, here is Albert One.
Radio Stadenhard. Radio Stadenhard. I venti d'azzurro. I venti d'azzurro. I love Italo Disco.
It's easy to laugh at my desire.
Laugh at my desire.
Too easy to catch my heart on fire.
But we will not love for your desire. Let's move on to Arek. And I want to say, because Gwen,
yes.
Mama Radio we say sometimes, but she's really right. She said, what a wonderful, nice people these fans from Rome are. So Arek, compliments, regards from Gwen, the Bats from the radio, to you over there.
Yes, yes. I live in Rome. Siamo de Roma.
that's really a Roman expression. Not da Roma, no, de Roma. Arek, can you say something about your feelings for an artist who is sadly not with us anymore? He's in heaven. He's an angel at the moment. But what were your feelings for Albert Juan? Because I have posted the picture, the photograph of Darek and Arek, you, in 2016 with Albertone. Can you explain something, for an example, how you feel meeting an artist?
For me, as for all the fans of Italo Disco, he was a great friend of body and heart.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, he passed away last year.
Yeah.
Albert's one problem was healed and he's overweight.
Yeah.
My work, I explain more maybe
later on.
After, my work is fact to help these people who have health, wellness and nutrition problems.
Yes.
Maybe if it started this job first, Albert was here with us listening to the interview. How do I know? He looks at us from above like an angel with his beautiful smile. His angel beautiful smile.
Yeah. Albert Juan was one of the artists who really had a heart for all people. He was always disponible. He was always there for a photograph, for a little chit-chat, for a little photo, I told you, an autograph, I wanted to say. He was always there, and also his lovely wife, Rosangela. She is a dear as well. But Arek is saying, well, later on I can ask him what his daily job at the moment is, but it's about benessere, it's about good feeling, and it's of course related to good nutrition and taking care of yourself. And we all know that Albert Juan had a problem with overweight. He had a problem. First, he was really the smoking guy in between all the other artists. So there was, of course, a health problem. But nevertheless, it was sad that the combination of some of those defects, so to speak, were at the end fatal for Albertone. And he didn't die of corona. Some people thought, well, maybe he was a victim of corona. No, he was not. It was really the humids and the other things, but the bad things behind his lungs. And of course, in combination with being a diabetic, he was really having troubles when he was in hospital. And they tried to help him, to save him. But Arek said, well, my job at the moment is just to help these kind of people maybe, and to make them realize that the health is between your ears, it's in your head, it's in your heart, and it's good nutrition. So, Arek, grazie. Later on, we're going to ask you what you really explained by this, because there is a reason that you spoke about it. First, I want to go to another good music track, because I want to have the wonderful music in the show selected by you guys. You have said also, and Darek said before, the voice of Mara Farina or the good friend Stefano Brignoli, these are really the perfect guys for a combination of a wonderful track. So you said, please do not forget Stefano Brignoli, do not forget Brand Image. So we have ready for you The Love in a Summer Night. Is that okay?
Yes, it's good. It's very good.
Okay.
Salutiamo Stefano Brignoli, nostro amico, grande amico.
Of course, Stefano, per te. And this is, of course, what we like about Brand Image for the fans and for all you there in the live chat and listening to the radio and to Eventi d'Azzurro. hit this still is. And after this one, we are going to listen to Radiorama, because they mentioned in Rome, Arek and Darek as well, Radiorama as a wonderful, well, what do you say? It's like a studio idea. But of course, after we have met Antonella and Oscar as the performing artists for Radiorama, but it was an idea, of course, just born in the studio. Arek, there is always a question between people who are interested in one another to ask. You are a young guy. You are 24 years old. Is it for you something extraordinary, something special to be Italo Disco fan? Or are there more young guys or girls in your family, in your friend circle, at the sports, who also like Italo Disco? Because sometimes people have the feeling, oh, well, it seems that I'm the only one liking Italo Disco. How's your situation? You are 24. Are there more friends like you liking this kind of music, or is it difficult to exchange?
It's difficult. It's difficult. I have friends listening rock music, listen modern music like rap, like hip hop. Like I don't like this music because in this music it's no melody. This music you listen mm-hmm. and. Pass 2-3 days and you not memory this music.
Well,
Italo disco is for 30, for 40, for 50 years beautiful songs. Always beautiful Italo disco
for Bimbi e Nonni.
this is the power. This is the power of songs of melody of Italo disco. No more am I. It's never that.
I have to explain. I have to explain to the listeners also that first we had an idea to include Ivan Bruno also in the video chat, but we discovered that it was too difficult here in the studio to have a divided screen and then maybe have the risk of losing the connection. So Ivan, if you're listening to us right now, and I'm sure that you do, excuse us for not sharing the video screen with you, because that was the intention first to do so. But now I'm going to ask Arek, there is something that you have mentioned about your work, because of course we can say the economic situation in Italy has been very, very bad because of the lockdowns, because of all the bad things. And it's happening all over the world that there is a difficulty for people to maybe lose their jobs, maybe to hold their jobs. You have something special, not only you, but also Ivan, Bruno, and also Remo. Can you explain what is your goal in life at the moment? Can you explain what you are doing? What is your work at the moment?
Speak Ivan or speak I in this?
I think better you. I think better you. Otherwise, it will be confusing. So better you.
Okay, I speak.
Yes.
The situation, the economic situation in Italy today is very difficult. There are few opportunities in Italy today. But that doesn't mean there aren't any opportunities. It's very difficult for lockdown, for COVID, for a situation. I find my job, and my job is network marketing, is smart working. I working at home. In this moment for COVID is good, because I don't see many person. I work at home on my phone, on my computer, and
so it's more like an e-business, an e-commerce.
E-commerce, yes, e-commerce. I have an e-commerce. I on Facebook my contact for e-commerce, for my e-commerce, for yeah. My email, mm-hmm. for my social page, and the post is on my page for Facebook.
Okay, I will interrupt because this is very important. If people, because you are a young guy and all over Europe, all over the world, people who are young have the same problems, or maybe not so young have the same problems. What can you do in this situation at the moment to work from home and to do something for yourself, for the world, to have, you'd call it benessere, to have a good feeling and a good health? You say something about your obligations, your work. So people can go to your Facebook page, there is Arek Danielak, and they find some information that you can post. Maybe also after this radio show, people can go to your Arek Danielak Facebook page and find all the information, correct?
All information, correct. My email, my e-commerce, and my social page, Instagram and Facebook.
Okay.
Only contact for my person.
Okay, because I don't...
For more information about my work, about my job, about benessere, good nutrition, health, and more information.
And talk about Italo Disco.
And Italo Disco, Italo Disco is number
That's
one.
The most important, because tonight is music. So after the following track, we're going to have a little chit-chat about maybe something else. But first, we go to the Radiorama. And I think you have selected really a wonderful track. We are really agreeing this is something really special. So listen to this one and you will find maybe the beginning a bit creepy, but the Italo Disco sound will make everybody happy, like the benessere in the music.
Yes, benessere per le orecchie.
Yeah. I visto, I sentito. Yeah. So let's move on, folks, to this wonderful Radiorama track, The Vampires, and then we go once again back to Arek. And you heard him. He's a young guy. He's not depressed. He's a happy person. And he tried to find something that he could do from home. So I think it's wonderful. We are not really the radio show, the radio program, to advise people about work. But this is how it works. That you can combine something to feel good. And what better to feel good with Italo Disco music. And with this radio, Stadena. My name is Marcello, we have Michiel, we have Maurizio, we have Arek and Darek, we have Ivan, we have Remo. We have so many good friends here in the live chat. I see so many good people, very attached and connected with the best of the music. What more can you wish for? Each and every Monday night, 9 o'clock sharp, we are here for you, for your benessere.
Noisy chance to in money. What's the time for vampires? Chopper of fancy girls. Come to inside it. Screeches all on Sundays. Come to inside it. You awake by the moonlight.
My addiction for the radio show to have a good beer. And I know Stuart is really understanding what I mean with a good beer. And so is his brother. You know, the famous Will Reed. I'm talking to the finest friends that we could find in Italy. And remember, he is a good contact. Because if there is going to be another party in Italy, and let's hope, let's cross fingers that really it will be possible in maybe the summer or the autumn of 2021, that we could have some meeting with artists and who knows, with friends. Let's hope that COVID-19 will be, well, under control, so to speak. And of course, he mentioned before, Darek, his papa, mentioned before Marek Kolodinski, and he was a great help. Yes. In 2016 also. And he's a good friend. You know, Space Sound Records, you already know the name of that company. It's Marek Kolodinski, so he's really the good guy also. So if you want and you need a contact in Italy, remember Arek and remember what he's doing, because it's interesting to know how a young guy like him is working from home. Arek, speaking about this situation, is there still a lockdown that you need to be inside, or can you move around? Because you were a sport guy, can you go out, or is it forbidden at the moment?
No, for sports, I like go out when the weather is good.
Yeah,
the condition of weather is good. I yeah. like to go out. I like to running. I do calisthenics. I do Muay Thai for 5 years, mm-hmm. and this is my sports. Sports is my life, like Italo Disco. Italo Disco, yeah. Sports is
it's a fine combination.
Yes, it's very good combination.
Okay,
and I the job, my job, mm-hmm. It's connected with. I like my job because it's connected with sport. I like sport. I like mm-hmm. good nutrition.
Yes.
I like health, be healthy.
Yes.
Wellness, and this is good connection. And
yeah.
I like to feel good, to train, to have a good nutrition, mm-hmm. and help the people who need. We have problem healthy problems like overweight mm-hmm. or need some way or other problems you know and this is and I work at home. I help people at home. I'm online. I connected online with people.
Exactly.
And I speak about healthy, good nutrition and wellness.
Well, and people can see what you are doing with the sports. You can see and find Arek on his Facebook page looking what he does with the sports. And also, if necessary, they can have information by Ivan, by Remo, because we mentioned your friends as well because, well, some things in life you can't do alone, and you need also the help and the support of other people like Ivan and Remo. They are good guys, so I think we can advise people, if you like Italo disco music, if you like to have a good contact in Italy, Arek is one of those guys. If I'm mentioning Benessere, the good health, here in Holland, if you go to a public place, you need to cover up your mouth. So you have to cover up. Can you understand what I mean? You have to cover up. You can't go to public. Is it necessary also in Italy to do so? Because I just want to know. I'm curious. If you want to go out in Rome to do some shopping, you need davanti la bocca. Hai bisogno o no? È un devuto magari. Devi portare.
Sì.
Ok, let's say.
Diciamo in Italia, a Roma, nutrition is very important.
Immagini, andiamo in supermercato, abbiamo bisogno di cover up la bocca, and it's,
sì.
Because in Holland you need to do so. And I want to say to you this, because have you seen, hai visto in Facebook l'immagine di Chiara Pedersoli, the wife of Vince Lanzini? Have you seen it? Mm. Hai visto o no?
No, non ho visto.
Ok, allora, per tutti quanti, for all you guys and girls here in the live chat or listening to the radio, there was a wonderful picture in Facebook today of Chiara Pedersoli. It's the wife of Vince Lanzini. She's a wonderful woman. And she has this thing in front of her mouth. And it's with the imagine, the picture of the disco band. So if she's going out, she can have this wonderful thing in front of her mouth with the disco band of her husband, of her man. I think it's wonderful. It's great. So one of the songs that you selected as well, and Darek, was the disco band, right?
Yes.
So we're going to listen for sure. Per forza, andiamo a disco band, a scotch. So let's move on. Here it is. For you.
Corona song.
music, and I told you before, it's really something special to speak directly to a fan what is in his blood, in his veins, for the Italo disco music, the passion with this, especially for Case. Case likes to hear another time the concert boy. Well, Case, here it is. But I'm going to talk about it and over it. So excuse me for that. Arek, I think you need to say something also, because I was referring to you being a young guy. What was your impression when you were entering Milano with the pre-party? With you remember, we had Vince Lanzini there, we had Linda Iorizzo, we had Fred Ventura, the Italo Connection. We had so many in the pre-party, and also thanks to Marek Kolodinski. What was your impression? What was your feeling, your emotion in Milano, 2016?
A very good emotion because I see the legend of Italo Disco, like Simona Zanini, Aldo Martinelli.
Esatto, yeah.
Oh, yes, Albert One. Albert One, yes, of memory of Albert One. And Fred Ventura and Crelascio, Gianni Coraini, Stefano Brignoli. And very, very more artists, Vince Lancini, and this Savage.
Of course.
Yes, Savage. And very, a beautiful party. It was a beautiful party because I saw a lot of artists. I spoke, talk with him, and music, Italo disco music was beautiful. It was beautiful feel this music life, it's very Vince Lancini show is beautiful. Gianni is.
And remember Anfrando Maiola, Cotto. Remember
Cotto, Anfrando Maiola.
Cotto, Alberto Maiola. Stilo.
Alberto Signorini Stilo. Yes.
So I'm going to ask you. Suppose that
Roberto Turati.
Of course, Robert Camero. All the people out there.
Gianluca Bergonzi,
Silvio Pozzoli, he was there. Silvio Pozzoli,
yes.
Giancarlo Pasquini, Aleph.
Aleph, yeah. Brian Ice, Fabrizio Rizzolo.
Yeah. We can go on.
The legend of Italo disco of this music.
Arek, suppose.
And Marcello, yeah. I see Marcello. The great
grazie.
Aventi d'Azzurro.
Grazie. Allora, senti, se sarà possibile quest'anno, dopo l'estate magari, if it will be possible, there will be, let's say, a special meeting, an unplugged meeting. Would you be there? Will you be part of that meeting? Because we are going to Italy, of course, and for you from Rome, I hope that you will be there. Is it possible that we can see each other again? And all the fans maybe listening to the radio right now, maybe they are a bit jealous and want to be in Italy as well. But suppose there isn't a party. Would you be there?
Yes. The party, I spar with Marcello. M equal AD and M. Dream team.
Operation. We can have a
we organize a party in Italy.
Okay.
I'm very proud for this. Me and my father and Marek and Marcello. Yes.
Oh, grazie. Okay, that's
you organize a very big party.
That could be a deal. That could be a deal for the future. Well,
the future
is now.
The future are beautiful. Beautiful. It's beautiful.
I'm going to say that we are going to play for you, Arek. One of your favorite tracks, "The Tension, My Dream," and then
Marek, the favorite tracks of Marek Kolodinski.
Also. Oh, and then after we're going to say goodbye. But please believe me, and please promise me that you won't go away. That you keep on listening to the show.
Yes, right? Keep on music.
Keep on music.
Always Italo
Disco. Okay. Let's move on to Tension. Here is My Dream. Arek, what a wonderful taste of music you have. You have selected with Darek the biggest and the wonderful tracks. And of course, there are more. But remember, please, ricordati, Arek, there are so many shows to come. So I will pick out more tunes, more songs in the upcoming weeks. So your hits, selected by Darek also, your hits will be included in my show also next week and the week after. So don't worry.
Okay.
We could not play everything, but I have a surprise for you after we say goodbye. And please hang on to the radio. The video may be connected. The video connection may be down after this saying ciao. But please ascolt la radio. Ascolta la radio, because we have wonderful tunes to come, especially also for you out there. So, Arek, is there something, because I ask your papa the same thing, is there something that you want to say, maybe to your family in Poland, maybe to your friends, maybe to Marek? What do you want to say to the fans of Italo Disco Music? Just a te la linea.
Yes. I say that I'm a young guy, but maybe with this interview, with this, the young guy like me, listening the Italo Disco. We started to listening Italo Disco.
Uh-huh.
Yes, this is my dream, because young people don't listening agli 80 song, dance agli 80 song.
But we have here in the live chat, we had here Speedy. He's a guy from
My friends
25. He's 25.
Yes, hear this music, and this is my for the fans and for my friend that listening this music. Yes.
Okay. Well,
this is
I have two songs for sure already now on the turntable. One is in Italian. That's a present and a surprise for you guys out there and for all.
Okay.
And the other one is in English, and it has been sung by Romano Baez. And it's about Dream. You never, maybe you never heard the track, but it's called Dream, Surprise Dream. So these are the tracks that I really wanted to give to you as a regalo for friendship. Grazie per essere così in amicizia con noi. Thank you for your friendship. And well, we will keep in touch. Arek, Darek, and your mama, we will keep in touch.
Yes.
Amici per sempre.
Grazie.
Amici per sempre.
Per sempre per l'Italo Disco.
Ok, grazie.
Grande.
So, grazie. Questo disco è dedicato a te, è dedicato a voi, anzi, Enrico Ruggeri, who is one of the co-composers of one of the first songs of Denaro. You remember To Meet Me, you remember, huh?
Yes,
go to the
place. Yes.
Enrico Ruggeri was one of the composers of that song. In 1985, he composed a song that I have on the turntable right now. I was a fan immediately of that song. Il futuro è un'ipotesi. So it is something for the future also for you guys. Of course, nobody can tell, but who knows what's going to happen? Il futuro è un'ipotesi. So I dedicate the song to you, to Ivan, to Remo, to all the fans of Italo Disco. So, con Romano Baez, voce. So, listen to this. The group name, Surprise. Well, it's really a surprise. Il pezzo si chiama Dream, the dream of Arek, the dream of so many young guys. So I hope that you like this one. 1989. It was correct the first time. So do it yourself as a record label, and I hope that I can surprise you with this track by Romano Baez. Listen to him, listen to him. This is a wonderful track. I like this so much. Me too. And of course, there is some doubts about the voice. It's really Romano Baez or not, but we know for a fact that he's behind the track for sure. So, Surprise, remember this one, Surprise, with the track called Dream. And there's also a female version of this track on the flip side of this vinyl. So glad that you listened to this wonderful show. We said goodbye to Arek and Darek. And of course, we have selected more songs in the style of what they like, because they also like Euro Disco, not only the Made in Italy sound, but, you know, so many people have their opinion in their head, in their heart about, okay, I like Italo Disco. And sometimes it appears to be the Euro Disco. And, you know, in the beginning, I really did mind that people were confused with what was made in Spain, what was made in France. But now you can say, what the heck, it doesn't matter. If you really like the song and it's really maybe the family sound of Made in Italy, who cares? We just like the music. And what's more, when it's surprising that a German artist is seeking contact and having the same opportunity and the need of making a song with an Italian artist like Ken Laszlo, I'm talking about Linda Yorizzo. Well, you know, the first night that we were in Milano, 2016, there was this pre-party co-organized with Marek Kolodinski, and so many people were there, and also you could meet them in the wild. There was just Ken Laszlo walking around, there was Linda Yorizzo walking around, Fred Ventura, Vince Lanzini, they were just there. You could touch them, you could speak to them, you could have a photograph with them. And in those days also, that's the power, I think, of the Eventi d'Azzurro parties. There is also a connection between the artists and the producers. Because in those days, I was very proud to say that there was also the beginning of new friendship again between Aldo Martinelli and Fabrizio Gatto and so many other people like... you remember Giancarlo Pasquini. I have a wonderful song coming up also from Giancarlo Pasquini, Aleph Sound. And he met also their people that he didn't see for ages. So that's the wonderful thing about music. It's connecting people. Well, the best of the connection maybe that I liked, because I do not like each and every song. I'm not just as mad in my head and in my heart to like each and every song. But this particular song, the cooperation between Linda Yorizzo and Ken Laszlo, I really like. And that's a bit, a little kind of magic. So please, Radio Stad Den Haag, Eventi d'Azzurro, Linda Yorizzo, Ken Laszlo. What's more beautiful than those two together in a wonderful video clip? Enjoy the sound. Enjoy the watching. Enjoy the live chat. Enjoy the radio. And stay with us.
This is Linda Jo Rizzo, and you can hear me on Radio Stadtenhof. This is the best music, the best sound around. Stay tuned. Enjoy. Bye.
Sound really, I dig it. I like it. I really like this kind of songs and the cooperation between those two. Really, friends together. Thank you. Grazie per la musica. I promise you to also to select a track by Aleph. Giancarlo Pasquini, of course, and he did wonderful job also for Flair Records. You know, Flair was a subsidiary of Modena. Cruising Records, the sound made in Modena in 1990, and just it may be a question to you, what did you do in 1990? Did you collect records? Did you have purchased the vinyl? Well, in September of that year, there was a Thomas and Schubert song, of course, an invented name, and the only one that you are going to listen to, and he created the song, he composed the song, is Giancarlo Pasquini. So you're going to listen to an Aleph song, but in the style of Flair Records. So it's a little bit of Eurobeat, and it's called In the Deep of My Heart. Well, if there's an expression appropriate for tonight, In the Deep of My Heart, it is really tonight. So here is Thomas and Schubert.
He's the one that stole my pocket.
I ain't never stole none in my life.
Yes,
no, no, hold. What's your name, boy? My name is Busy B, sir. Busy who?
right? This is what's all about. If you like the Isle of Sound, maybe you missed this one. 1990, Thomas and Schubert was just the Aka, and In the Deep of My Heart was the title of the track. So I have two tracks more. I had the intention of one, but of course I changed my mind. Just in a moment, in a moment, I can change my mind. And I have two tracks left over. So one could be The Ciao Boys by Barbara. And I think you will like it because it has been co-written by Gino Carilla. And everybody knows who is Gino Carilla. But now I think it's also a proper theme to have on the turntable. The one that was made by Eddie Miami and Fred Ventura. Well, the other way around, maybe. Fred Ventura and Eddie Miami. And it has been pressed on vinyl, the white vinyl, on Eventi D'Azzurro label. So go to the website, eventirecords.com, if you like. And I think it's appropriate also because if you listened carefully to Arek, he's a young guy. He's full of spirit and good hope for the future to have his e-commerce with his friends. Benessere, I can repeat it. It's really Italian of saying to feel good. And it's not only because you have a dream to follow. If you have the good nutrition, you have the good food. But of course, it's a combination of all. It's between your ears. It's in your heart. It's in your mind. And just have a little sport. Have a little good food, etc., etc. But also, well, we have said it so many times, good music. Well, and the title of the track, A New Tomorrow, is, I think, something really, really special for this show. So, let's move on to Federico di Bonaventura, better known as Fred Ventura, and with his companion in music, Paolo Cozzetti, Italo Connection. They make so many beautiful things. And this is The New Tomorrow. It's the Italo Connection remix, the flip side of the record that we play for you. And I'm so proud of this production and I like it so much. So this is not the last track of tonight, but the forelast. So we end with Barbara, but first this one, A New Tomorrow. Remember, our music is helping you for a new tomorrow.
Hi, I'm Fred Ventura. I want to wish you happy 2021 and let's hope it's going to be a better year than 2020. Ciao!
Just run away from me, forget the things you fear. a solution coming. There are no tears to dry. Leave all the bad behind. This is the way.
About friendship and benessere stasera, tonight. If I can mention just one guy, just like I mentioned Albertone, Alberto Carpani, Rosangela Bonati, Fred Ventura, he is, well, he appeared to be for so many people a good friend, but for me, he's like a fratello. He's like also a guy from the heart. We like family, and it feels so good. Sometimes you even think you don't have to explain it anymore because it's there. The feeling is good, the feeling is there. But nevertheless, I feel good if I can make you also know about this feeling. Music for me is this kind of emotion, and that's why I think I need to say it once again that Federico di Bonaventura is also, well, one that is really precious to me, really precious. Grazie Federico, grazie Fred. Let's move on to the last one, Gino Carria. Well, he's an angel as well. And this was sung by a girl named Virginelle. If you know the name Virginelle, she was the real singer. But on the cover, there is Barbara. I don't know if you can see it. Oh my God, I did it nearly perfect. Barbara.
She looks a little bit like Paul Stanley.
Ciao, okay. Boris. She also signed.
Okay.
Signed the thing for me. Oh my God.
Oh God.
And she has been in Holland. She has been in Holland. Who when? Can remember for Christmas Wall, Durekel, High Fashion? Yeah. She was here. She was here with us. We invented Azzurro. Oh my God. What a memory. What a time. The Ciao Boys, I think it's good to say goodnight to you. Thank you for sharing our emotions tonight, because you are wonderful. I love you. Bye. Thank you, Michiel. Thank you, Mauricio. Ciao a tutti. Buonanotte. Ciao, ciao.
Everybody's dancing. Nou, die vrouw had wel even willen ontmoeten eigenlijk. Maar goed, dit terzijde. Ik heb haar niet kunnen zien. Nou, dames en heren, even maar op zijn Nederlands. Want we hebben de hele tijd al Engels gehoord van Marcello D'Azzurro in deze Eventi D'Azzurro voor deze 11e alweer, januari van dit jaar. Volgende week is het natuurlijk weer. En vergeet ook trouwens even aanstaande vrijdag niet. Want aanstaande vrijdag hebben wij onze grote man met de Classic Café. Hij is dan ook weer aanwezig. Erwin van Rijn zal er weer de zender gaan vervuilen. Hier zo op woensdagavond vanaf 8 uur ben je dan van harte welkom. En natuurlijk Freaky Friday Night hou je ook in de gaten. Ook de zaterdagavond met Ingrid Elting. Voor de rest zeg ik tot zondag. Zondag is er weer een douche-co, je douche vol met disco. En dan gaan we terug naar het jaar 1985. Het jaar toen ik begon te werken bij BCC. Nou, dat is bijna 36 jaar geleden, dames en heren. Goed, bedankt je voor het luisteren en ik zou zeggen tot aanstaande zondag.
Iedere zondag tussen 5 en 7, Michiel van der Brugge in Douche-co. Met natuurlijk een terugblik naar de Haagse flitsende 50 uit de 80's. Jouw douche vol met disco. Elke zondag tussen 5 en 7 op Radio Stad.
Every Sunday evening, 8 p.m. Central European Time, we spin those old school dance hits, Italo disco and high energy from the 80s. www.radiostopdenhaag.no. Live with your requests. Go to our website, click the box, and mail us your request. Radio Stop Den Haag.